हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस टुडे अबाउट पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन। पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन इज नथिंग बट अ डिवाइस इज यूज्ड फॉर जीन क्लोनिंग और जीन मल्टीप्लिकेशन इन विट्रो। बेसिकली वी टेक अ डीएनए स्ट्रैंड, वी रिमूव इट आउटसाइड द बॉडी एंड वी ऑब्टेन मेनी 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 कॉपीज ऑफ द सेम डीएनए सैंपल। दिस इज डन इन पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन। It is a method device which is used to obtain many copies of a desired gene outside the body. We use PCR technique, polymerase chain reaction technique, to amplify. Amplify means to get many copies of the gene of interest. In 1985, Carey Mullis, he had discovered the principle and technique of PCR, polymerase chain reaction, which is used to obtain many copies of a desired gene outside the body. This is how the PCR machine looks like. Using this PCR machine, we can obtain billion copies of a desired segments of a DNA or a RNA in very, very little time. In few hours, from one sample of DNA, we can get billions of copies of this DNA or RNA in very less time. That too, it is with great accuracy and specificity. There is very, very, very rare chances of any mistake of nucleotide sequences. This device use, it is called as a thermal cycler. The different substances that are required to carry out PCR or polymerase chain reaction are: desired segment is needed, of which we want copies, which is to be amplified. We also need molecules of deoxyribonucleotide phosphates, because we want to form many copies of the DNA. We need two primer molecules, excess two primer molecules for one chain. We need heat stable DNA polymerase enzyme, which is called as TAC polymerase, which is obtained from a bacteria, Thermoacetus bacteria. And we also need appropriate quantities of magnesium ions, because this reaction will be occurring in presence of magnesium ions. So we need desired gene. We need molecules of DNTPs, that is deoxyribonucleotide phosphates. We need two primer molecules. We need an enzyme, TAC polymerase enzyme, and magnesium ions. Now what is done in mechanism of PCR? First, a DNA segment is taken, of which we want to make obtain many copies. Two primer molecules are taken, four DNTPs, and all this is mixed in an Eppendorf tube. And then three steps are carried out. First step is denaturation, second is annealing, and third is primary extension. So the three steps are denaturation, annealing, primer extension. Let us see one by one what happens in denaturation. So this is the desired segment of DNA. We are taking this. We are heating the reaction mixture to 90 to 98 degree, very, very high temperature. What happens to the strands, two strands of the desired gene or the DNA? They get separated. So we are denaturing, we are separating this one strand and this strand from one another by heating it to a temperature of 90 to 98 degree. So you can see the two strands are separated from one another. Second step is annealing. Annealing means joining. These DNA strands which are separated, we are going to cool it down to 40 to 60 degree centigrade, and then we are going to anneal, join, fix what? Primers having complementary sequences. So we will complementary sequences primer, we are going to anneal or join over here. So annealing is a method where we are joining RNA primers having complementary DNA sequences. So you can see the third step is primer extension. So annealing of primer is occurring. You can see this is primer 1, this is primer 2, and they are annealed. They are having opposite nucleotide sequences, and then we again increase the temperature to 70 to 75 degrees centigrade from 40, and in presence of enzyme, thermostable enzyme TAC DNA polymerase, Thermus aquaticus is TAC polymerase obtained from a bacteria, and this enzyme is stable at high temperatures also, it doesn't get denatured. So in presence of TAC DNA polymerase, we are obtaining the double copies, the double stranded DNA. So this DNA is used as a template strand, again a template strand, RNA primer, and then the nucleotide sequences will be joining complementary, and from one strand we will develop two strands, as you can see in this picture. So we now got two copies of DNA, which we started from first copy. two copies of desired gene is obtained. This is renaturation. Renaturation, formation of two DNA copies. Such one cycle, it takes place around 3 to 4 minutes. And to begin for the second cycle, again what is to be done? Again the temperature is increased, again DNA is heated, again these double strands are now converted into single strands, and again the process is continued similarly. In an automatic thermal cycler, the above three steps are automatically repeated 20 to 30 times. Thus, at the end of the three cycles, at 20 to 30 times, we get 2 raised to n copies of DNA segments, which are in millions. Once a desired number of cycles are completed, then what is done? These DNA segments, these hundreds and billions of copies which we obtain, they are purified by using the technique of gel electrophoresis. And this desired gene then either can be inserted in a cloning vector or it can be stored in the form of a gene library. So I hope you understood, students, everything about PCR. Now in next video, we will discuss about what are restriction enzymes. Thank you.